Welcome to a new fragrance review. Today, I'm going to tell you the actual difference between niche and designer fragrance. So, usually there's two mainstream ideas of what is niche and what is designer. And those two mainstream ideas are not what I would consider appropriate. I would say that the term niche and the term designer in both of these use, maybe not fully in both, but means nothing. It's not a good way to use these terms, and I'm gonna even give examples. So those two ways that are explained are either designer fragrance are cheaply made fragrance, and niche fragrance are high quality fragrance that are used with good ingredients and everything. The other way it's said is that designer fragrance are a company that makes stuff that is not fragrance, and niche fragrance company that only make fragrance. And the problem with this would be that for the first category, that there's low quality and good quality, like designer is low, niche is high, I would go with Parfum de Marly. I know a lot of people would start to defend Parfum de Marly, but Parfum de Marly is a niche fragrance house. It's a niche fragrance house for many reasons, even if you consider the second way of talking about niche fragrance. And even though they have a lot of great fragrance, they are not ultra high quality that you would assume. It's blending as well or everything, but there's fragrance. If you go with Percival, for example, well, Percival is nice and everything, but it's always compared to a designer fragrance, and maybe the quality is a bit different, and that designer fragrance doesn't exist anymore, which is I forgot the name of the fragrance, but it's still a blue fragrance that doesn't bring anything more in the market than just being some blue fragrance. Also, if you look at Erod, I would say that the fragrance is really bad for what it is. It's a really bad deal. It's not like super bad, it doesn't smell nasty or anything, but it's still something that you pay a couple hundred dollars for, so I would expect more out of that amount of money, and would make it not. It's a niche fragrance, but it doesn't have the quality, the high quality that you will assume from niche fragrance. I will not go with all the Parfum de Marly there, but still. Also, there's other, I'm sure you can find other company that only make fragrance that do low quality. If you go with only making fragrance being the way of making a niche and a designer, then Creed is not a niche fragrance house, even though it's the king of the Aventus, the king of the fragrance. It's like the most niche fragrance house ever. They make candles, and candles are not perfume, so that doesn't work either. Also, if you go with the designer side, they're a company that makes really good quality of fragrance. If you look at Prada, they're known for making good quality fragrance, but still, Prada is a designer. The problem with that is we're using designer and niche as two opposites. One, they don't mean anything. It's like you will say that there are blue fragrance and there are hot fragrance. There are concepts that means totally different things. A designer, of course, is a company that will design stuff. So if we would go with some example, Tom Ford designed clothes, so therefore it's a designer. If you look at Lalique, they design glassware, crystal stuff. So it's a designer. Now a lot of people will put company like Guerlain to designer, but they design nothing. They make perfume and they make makeup. The thing is that makeup is not a design. Even worse than that, I think they outsource all of their stuff for design. So they're not a designer even for their bottle. If you look at MAC, which is a makeup company, it is absolutely what people consider a designer fragrance, but again, they make perfume and makeup, especially makeup. So they are not a designer fragrance with that specific way to describe what a designer fragrance is, because they're not a designer. Now, if you look at niche as a business standpoint, what a niche is a narrow market. There's a broad market and there's a narrow market. A niche fragrance house would be a fragrance house that has a narrow market. And even if it's not just for your house, if it's a designer house, a niche designer house would be a designer house that have a small market. For example, Tom Ford and Lalique are niche designer house. You won't buy a $10,000 shirt. I mean, maybe you will, but most people won't do this. They won't buy a $10,000 shirt. If you can afford a $10,000 shirt just for fun, because I mean, why would you buy stuff super cheap like $5,000 shirt? I mean, if you're that kind of person, yeah, you're in that niche. But if you're not someone that would pay $10,000 for a shirt, well, Tom Ford is not for you. You're not in that niche. The same for Lalique. If you're not gonna pay a couple thousand dollars on some decoration in your house, or you're not in their niche, and their niche for any other market. If you go with, it's not just like for rich people. If you go with Creed, for example, the niche for Creed are not necessarily wealthy people, even though the people they target are wealthy, the people they are targeting are actually powerful people. They don't make fragrance for some random person that would just do some online stuff and make $1 million a month. They don't do fragrance for those people. They make fragrance for people that are famous, people that are like owning a huge business, like Jeff Bezos, for example, or for the president of the United States, for the queen, for people of power and influence. This is their target market. And this is the reason also before a couple of years ago, you couldn't buy Creed fragrance because Creed decided if you were worthy of buying their fragrance or not, until they decided to make it available for the public. Sum up everything I said, a designer is someone that make design. They can sell fragrance or not. But the opposite of a designer would be, in that case, just a fragrance house. If they only do fragrance house. Or technically there would be a third category that is an other kind of company of any sort that also sell fragrance. Like MAC, which is not a designer and it's not a fragrance house. It's makeup company. It's a cosmetic company. And if you go with the quality standpoint, there's low quality and high quality. Also, doesn't matter. There's fragrances that are expensive that are low quality, fragrances that are cheap that are high quality. Also, the quality is extremely subjective. For example, Creed, a lot of people say that they are bad quality because they don't last long. But Creed are known to use extremely high quality ingredient. And people will say that the longevity of a fragrance is a good measure of the quality. Other people like me will say that fragrance like fragrance house like Parfum de Marly are not super high quality because they're not doing new things to revolutionize the market, and they're just doing a lot of blue stuff with a lot of mass appealing stuff. So even though they're not bad quality, they don't hold the standard I would consider high quality. So it's really subjective what quality actually is. You know, perfumery is an art form. If you look at painting, for example, there's people that draw, you know, like what I at the back there, nice little bridge with the Tour Eiffel there and stuff like that. There's people that paint this, and there are people that stick paintbrush in their ass and just paint line on the and like weird stuff on the canvas and sell their painting for thousands and thousands of dollars. So what is quality in there? Really, the quality is extremely subjective. Even the blend, I would say that the blend of the perfume is really makes the quality. It's like not necessarily makes the quality if it's of quality or not. Of more, it's the blend and the person together that will decide if the fragrance is quality or not. Like Aventus, some people say it's high quality, some will say it's low because of the longevity. Like Sauvage, some would say it's high quality, some would say it's low. Like any fragrance, in fact. I think they shouldn't be at that division of niche and designer. It's pointless. It doesn't explain well at all what people are trying to explain with it. I think it's us trying to label stuff that makes us use those kind of label. And I feel the labeling that was done was just bad. I don't have any way to replace designer and any way to replace niche because they all mean different thing. I think if the fragrance is mass appealing, you should say it's mass appealing, not it's designer. If you say that the fragrance is bold, you should say it's a bold fragrance. It's a challenging fragrance, not it's a niche fragrance. I mean, those terms are really misused. Say what the fragrance is, describe it with your heart and not with some weird label that in the end are meaningless. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I really had that to share. It's been a long time that I want to talk about that subject. And if you agree or disagree with me, write it in the comment. I know there's a lot to talk about this, and I know some people suggested different terminology to replace niche and designer, to replace one or the other. And if you have any of those kind of terminology that you think would be good to use, write it in the comment. So, thanks for watching, and see you soon.